Father Andrew Torma, a missionary of the Sacred Heart. I became a pastor here at St. Michael's after I had spent 5 years as vocation director for the Missionaries of the Sacred Heart. I've been a priest for about 39 years, and this is one of the most challenging ministries I've had. I was with some friends who had come to visit me in Chicago. I said to them, "Would you like to see a very beautiful church?" Just a quick visit, and I was just impressed by it. And the person who had let me in just happened to mention the parish had been without a pastor for 2 years. I got very excited about that. And since I was looking for a new ministry, I thought about it and discussed it with them. And when they finally went back home 3 days later, my friend Peg said to me, "Well, are you going to write the letter to the bishop?" And I says, "Well, I guess so." I wasn't ready to make a commitment. 7 months after I was appointed administrator, I asked to be named pastor, and I was. Now, one of the most challenging aspects of being pastor at St. Michael Archangel Parish is that it's a parish in transition, and the transition's been going on for quite a while. The steel industry closed in about 1985, and the thousands of parishioners of St. Michael's and the other parishes in this area all became unemployed. And they began to move out. And then the community finished making its transition. And that is the challenge. St. Michael Archangel Church was built in the early 1900s, designed by Brinkman, who had built many churches in Chicago. When the parishioners of Immaculate Conception came to start St. Michael's Church, they had the idea that maybe this could be the cathedral for the Archbishop. And many people who come to visit St. Michael's say, "This looks like a cathedral." Brinkman had had a lot of experience building churches, and he brought it all together in this one. This turned out to be his last big church that he built. He designed the interior of the church to reflect the Polish tradition of their faith. All these stained glass windows reflect the Polish heritage, the holy people of the heritage of the Polish people. The primary stained glass window at the top of the sanctuary, right behind the reredos there, is that of Our Lady of Częstochowa. Originally, the reredos was only half the height, and you could see that beautiful stained glass window of Our Lady of Częstochowa. In the many stained glass windows, there's three that are very important in this church that stand out. The one to my right is the Last Judgment, or the Christ the King, which we celebrate on the last Sunday of Ordinary Time. The one on the left is the Pentecost with Mary and the 12 apostles in the upper room of Pentecost. And the third one is the stained glass window of the patron of this parish, St. Michael.
Quod obiernatus est.
The original population of St. Michael Parish was the Polish immigrant. In 1892, 500 parishioners were taken from Immaculate Conception Parish, just a mile down south of us, and sent here to build St. Michael Archangel Parish.
My name is Elizabeth, and I'm happy to be in this beautiful church because I'm living so close to this neighborhood. And my aunt used to be the parishioner, and she passed away, and I'm staying. And that's why I even very committed with the other churches on the north side, but I just want to be here because this is the beautiful church. And I'm just sometimes sorry that the people sometimes, you know, like Polish people, when I talk, they telling this is the pearl on the desert, like this St. Michael church is so beautiful and it's so nice. And I'm just sometimes feeling sorry for people, they not coming so to the church. That's why I wake up in the morning, I want to be here. I go like every day to just chant Jehovah, Holy Mary, and I'm talking to her. I just came, I want to always thank you her for everything what she giving.
One of the important aspects of being a pastor here is the diversity of the parish. The larger civil community is two-thirds African-American, which also includes many immigrants from Africa, and one-third Hispanic.
My name is Martha Zekin, and I'm a member of this church, St. Michael's, the Archangel. I used to live in the east side of Chicago. Behind us is Our Lady of Guadalupe, and she is the Our Lady from Mexico. And, well, actually, she's the Lady from the United States, from the Americas. She's done many miracles, many wonders for us in Mexico and here in the United States. The reason why I decided to become a member here of St. Michael's is because first, of course, the church is gorgeous. And I'm a CCD teacher for the confirmation here. And I remember this parish years ago when my sister was married. She was married in this parish. And I thought it was gorgeous. And I just feel happy that I'm able to come and be part of this parish. And I'm also a communion minister, a Eucharistic minister.
Years. now at St. Michael. I do enjoy what I do. And right now I'm actually updating our Facebook page and our website just for the current events about our Thanksgiving Mass that is coming up. We also have Corazón a Corazón, which is a community, you can say like an outreach program that's on the second floor that offers ESL and computer literacy for everyone that, you know, that would like to learn.
In 1926, the pastor established the first St. Michael School. He had called in the sisters from Poland because the students were of Polish immigrants. One of the problems with education in the United States at the time was that not all people were able to receive an education, especially the poor. And then the parents wanted the Catholic tradition to be passed on to their children. So the first school was built over in what is now the parking lot. It was built on top of the church. Then they built this school here, and this original school became a high school for girls. So this was the elementary school, grades 1 through 8, and the high school for girls was in the original school. We now have about 133 students in our school. And they spoke the Polish language, which is what the language of the children spoke. And then eventually the second and third generations were all English-speaking students. Each year is a struggle to keep the population of the school high enough so that we can meet our expenses. We can no longer provide a free education as was done in the early years. We offer a lot of scholarships in order for the people of the neighborhood to be able to afford a Catholic education.
It helps, it keeps it just warm enough that the ground won't freeze. But even better than that, when the snow comes, the snow is like a second blanket.
What?
And the snow keeps the heat in the ground.
Doesn't it try to
water it
when the snow melts?
And that's it. And then when the snow melts, it waters it, and then it starts getting warm. The water and the warmth tells the plant to grow roots, and then they'll start growing the stem, and up comes the green stem, and from the green stem comes the
red tulip.
Yeah.
How
yeah.
Does it look?
So that's what you're going to. No, they're just pretty to look at.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
The custom of the children coming to Mass has changed a lot. The old parishioners who came to St. Michael's School tell me that they had to go to school every day, and that was part of their religion class. Today, we have Mass once a week for the children on a Wednesday morning at 8 o'clock.
Be healed, as the youngest brother was still alive. The king appealed to him, not with no words, but with promises and unintelligible. Please turn to page 220 in the slide.
Lord, when your glory appears, my joy will be full.
Hear, O Lord, this soup, attend my outcry, hearken my own prayer from my lips without deceit.
Most of the children are not Catholic, and it really is a strange experience to be having all the children come up and only less than 50% do receive communion. The rest we give a blessing to. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.